Hi, Trance Recapper here. I'm going to share with you a dark and twisted story that's guaranteed to give you nightmares. It's about a boy who seems to have 9 lives, but his mother kills him every year on his birthday. Prepare yourself, it's not for the faint of heart. The story begins on Louis Drax's 9th birthday. Louis Drax has been in a lot of accidents since he was born, but he has lived through them all. He was born by accident, and a lamp fell on him when he was only 4 months old. He's been bitten by spiders, stung by bees, shocked by electricity, and had food poisoning more than once. He's also had a number of diseases, such as meningitis. This child doesn't seem to get sick, and his mother Natalie calls him an angel. He may also be like a cat, and his 9th year may be his last. On Louis's 9th birthday, he, his mother, and his father, Peter, go on a picnic near a cliff, and Louis ends up falling into the water. He is cold underwater, and a strange voice that sounds like a growl tells him that this is his 9th life. A few minutes later, Detective Dalton and her team show up because 2 hitchhikers who saw Natalie nearby called the police. Mother and son are saved, but Peter can't be found anywhere. Louis is taken to the hospital, where Dr. Janik tries to help as much as he can. Sadly, Louis dies. But when the body is taken to the morgue, it starts shaking, so doctors bring it back to the emergency room. Dr. Alan Pascal is giving a TED talk about his book, which is about what happens to the brain when a person is in a coma. He talks about how he used to sleepwalk as a child, and how he's been looking for that lost dimension that the brain goes into ever since. Then, Janik calls and asks him to come to the hospital and take over Louis's case. He finds out that the boy has been dead for 2 hours and is now in a coma with a lot of broken bones and organs that are in danger. Alan also gets to meet Natalie. He says that Louis is a medical miracle and promises to bring him back. In the meantime, while Louis is unconscious, his mind is searching for old memories to tell the voice. Natalie was always looking out for Louis because he was a bad boy, so she sent him to see Dr. Perez for therapy. The doctor told Louis that anything he told Perez would stay between them. Perez also finds Louis's rudeness funny. Louis doesn't always answer questions, though. For example, once he said he didn't think he'd grow up, but he never said why. When Perez asks Louis if he is on purpose making things go wrong, the boy changes the subject. Louis read the doctor's book and learned that Perez hypnotists some of his patients. He wonders if Perez won't try on him because he's a wacko boy and not a typical troubled child. Back in the present, Alan asks Janik to tell him more about what happened. The police think that Peter pushed Louis and is now on the run, so they will put an officer at the hospital's front desk. Alan talks to Louis as often as he can to let him know it's okay to come back. Later, Dalton stops by to talk to the doctors about what she knows about Louis so far. She tells them that he used to go to therapy, was disruptive at school, didn't have any friends, and didn't fit in, which is why the other boys called him Wacko Boy. Alan tells Dalton that Louis has been in a lot of accidents in the past. Dalton says that Louis's previous doctors think he did it on purpose to get attention, but neither she nor Alan believe that because Louis has been in accidents since he was a baby. Alan also thinks about whether or not Peter was violent, but Dalton doesn't say anything about that. After that, Alan takes Natalie for a walk to try to make her feel better. In Louis's mind, memories are coming and going quickly. Some are happy, like when Natalie took care of him or when the family went to the aquarium. Others are scary, like when Natalie and Peter fought or when Alan spent a lot of time with Natalie in the hospital when she came to see her son. One night, the mysterious voice shows up as a big seaweed monster who wants to hear Louis's story again and again. The next story is about when Peter took him to SeaWorld, and they ran into Peter's ex-wife Caitlin, who had remarried and now had 3 kids from her second marriage. Later, Peter asked Louis not to tell Natalie about this meeting because she was very sensitive. Louis said he wouldn't tell anyone, but as soon as they got home, he did. This made his parents fight, which Louis tried to ignore. The next time he went to therapy, Louis told Perez that he didn't keep the secret because he knew his parents didn't love each other, but that they wouldn't get a divorce because of him. Peter wasn't his real father. He also knew. Later, Louis asked Peter why he stopped boxing. Peter told him that Natalie asked him to stop and that he became a father. A few days later, Alan and his wife Sophie go to a party that Janik has put together. Alan is surprised to see that Natalie is also there, and he can't take his eyes off of her. Sophie notices this and thinks that her marriage isn't going so well already. When Alan finally gets to talk to Natalie, Sophie interrupts them. This makes the atmosphere very tense, which stays with them when they go home. Natalie brings Louis Hamster to the hospital the next day in hopes that it will help her son. Most of the time, animals aren't allowed, but Talon lets her bring hers. Natalie says that Louis loves his pet, but the truth is that this is his third hamster, and he killed the first two. When Perez asked him about it, Louis told him about a secret rule that said if you owned a small animal, and it lived more than 2 years, you could kill it because you owned it. Perez was shocked to hear this and tried to get Louis to talk about Peter by asking him where he heard it. At the end of the session, Perez told Natalie about his worries. Natalie was upset by Perez's comments, so she decided to stop sending Peter to therapy. Louis sent Perez a letter full of hamster poop because he shared things that Perez had sworn wouldn't leave the room. The seaweed monster is listening to this story right now, and he is wondering why Louis hates men so much. The boy says that bad things happen to his mom because of men. Alan asks Natalie why she stopped seeing Perez for therapy right before the cliff accident. Natalie says that she used to think that Perez was trying to make her hate her husband, but now she's starting to think that maybe he was right. Since Alan is so understanding, Natalie tells him what happened on Louis' birthday. She and Peter had a fight because Peter didn't like that she had stopped Louis' therapy. Peter got mean, which scared Louis, who ran to the edge to get away. His parents chased after him and tried to catch him, but Louis fell as they struggled. Alan asks Natalie if Peter has ever been violent, but she doesn't answer. Instead, she tells him she's known Peter since she was 18, which makes him the only man she's ever been with. Alan thinks that Natalie deserves better, so he and Natalie end up kissing, which can be seen from the windows of the hospital. This includes the room where Louis is, who gets up all of a sudden and looks at him with a red eye. Alan and the nurse run to check on Louis, who is trying to say something. He only gets to whisper "my dad" before Natalie hugs him, and he falls back into his coma. Then Louis thinks about another memory. The night his parents broke up, Peter came to say goodbye because he was leaving with his grandmother for a while to give Natalie some space, but he promised that he would always be there for his son. Alan stays up late doing tests to try to figure out what happened, but nothing makes sense. He keeps talking to Louis and even reads him his favorite book tonight. Alan hears a noise and follows a trail of seaweed, spider webs, and mud into a room where the seaweed monster is hiding. Alan sees Louis, but before he can do anything, he wakes up next to Louis and realizes it was all a dream. A few days later, Alan hangs out with Janik, who notices that he's tired. Alan admits that he hasn't been sleeping well, and that things are worse than ever with Sophie. Janik wonders if Alan has been seeing Natalie since the kiss in the garden was seen by everyone in the hospital. Natalie calls and asks Alan for help because she thinks Peter has been in the house. This ends their little chat. When Alan gets there, Natalie shows him a letter written in childish handwriting and signed by Louis that she found in the mailbox. The text itself is also scary. Louis tells Natalie to stay away from Alan because he's interested in her and men always hurt her. Bad things will happen if she doesn't listen. Alan tells Natalie to take the letter to the police, where an expert finds that the person who wrote it didn't use their dominant hand, likely to hide their identity. Natalie is told by Dalton not to stay in her house for now, and Alan offers her a room in the hospital since she doesn't have any family or friends. Before they leave, Dalton also tells Alan, for his own safety, that he shouldn't meet up with Natalie. Alan goes to see Perez the next day, who now works in a mental hospital. Perez says he used to think Louis caused the accidents on purpose to get attention, but the pieces didn't always fit. He shows Alan the letter with the hamster droppings, which also has a message about how much Louis hates Perez for telling his secrets to others. Alan gives Perez a copy of the letter in return, and Perez confirms that the letter is written exactly the way Louis talks. In the meantime, Louis thinks back to the day of the incident. Peter came back just to help his son celebrate his birthday, and he gave him the third hamster as a gift. Peter told Natalie in the car that he wanted Louis to stay with him for his 2-week break. Natalie didn't like the idea, but she didn't have a good reason to say no. So, she said Peter was lost. He said that wasn't true, and after a short, calm argument, Louis got the map so he could help his dad. But instead of common roads, he finds a map of his own brain on the paper. Sophie shows up at Alan's office in the late evening. She brought him a mysterious letter written in the same handwriting as the one Natalie got, since he doesn't spend much time at home anymore. Sophie had already looked inside, and what she saw made her feel so bad that she left without saying a word. Also signed by Louis, this letter tells Alan to leave his mother alone. Alan says that Louis couldn't have written the letters because he was just having a muscle spasm when he sat up. Dalton then comes over to look into it. As Dalton comes up with new ideas, she asks Alan what Natalie thinks happened at the picnic. Then she tells Alan that Louis' real father isn't Peter, and that Natalie gave Louis up for adoption when he was a baby. After the police leave, Alan talks to Natalie and asks her why she lied when she said she had only been with one guy. Natalie says that they didn't agree to have Louis, and that his birth almost killed them both. Since then, she has felt like she is surrounded by people who want to hurt her. Alan assures her that she is safe with him, and the two of them move their relationship forward. Back to Louis' memory of the picnic, Peter was angry that Natalie had stopped Louis' therapy, but he didn't say much about it because he didn't want to upset his son. At the same time, Natalie is talking to him in the present and telling him how she and Peter met. After one of Louis' big accidents, she had called Peter to ask for his help while she waited for the results of the surgery. The doctors thought he was her husband, and a year later, they did get married, even though Peter didn't really love Caitlin and liked Natalie more. Louis' mind sees her and hates how much she talks. So the seaweed monster takes him away to finally show him the truth. In the meantime, the police are making everyone who works at the hospital write something so they can compare their handwriting to the writing on the letters. At that moment, they could hear a commotion coming from Louis' room. Violet, Peter's mother, had come to see her grandson, but she and Natalie hate each other and were now fighting. Alan takes Violet to his office and finds out that Natalie has been trying to stop Violet from seeing Louis since Peter went missing. Peter hasn't talked to his mother, but Violet is sure he didn't do anything because he loved that kid more than himself. In fact, Louis is the only reason Peter stayed with Natalie for so long. Violet liked Caitlin better, and she thinks that Natalie used lies and tricks to get Peter away from her. She also thinks Natalie is lying to Alan when she says she doesn't have any family and that Louis' birth was forced. Dalton suddenly comes in and tells them that Peter's body has been found in a cave near the cliff. This is bad news. Back in Louis' mind, the seaweed monster makes the kid jump into the water with him, and they swim until they reach a dark cave. Here, Louis finds out that the monster is his own version of Peter. Peter then tells Louis what really happened. He loved Caitlin more than anyone else, but he felt bad for Natalie because she was always sad. Peter got rid of Caitlin and married Natalie because she was the one who needed him the most. He found out too late that Natalie always cried because she liked it when people felt bad for her more than when they laughed. He didn't leave because he loved Louis more than he loved himself. Peter has never thought Louis was weird. In fact, he has always been proud of him. Peter's seaweed-covered body is being looked at by a doctor in the morgue. It's already broken down a lot, which means Peter has been dead for days. He and Louis fell into the water together, but Peter was pulled into a cave by the current, making him hard to find. The lab also tells the police that Peter didn't write the letters, which doesn't come as much of a surprise at this point. Alan wakes up at the hospital after sleeping too long by accident. The nurse tells him she didn't wake him up because he was sleepwalking. He must have gone to the desk, written a prescription, and then thrown it away before going back to his seat. The nurse kept that prescription, and when Alan looks at it, he is shocked to see that Natalie was given dangerous amounts of insulin and chloroform in the letters. Alan goes to the police, and they check the security cameras to see if what the nurse said is true. He thinks that Louis is controlling his mind while he sleeps, and that he is trying to tell them something. Dalton thinks it's a crazy idea, and even though Alan's handwriting does match the letters, he's not a suspect. He didn't know the family before they came to the hospital, and it can't be a coincidence that both Louis and Peter fell that day. Alan goes to see Perez to ask if he ever thought Natalie was involved in the accident. He does this because he can see where this is going. Perez agrees with Alan that his theory is crazy, but he agrees to hypnotize him to prove it. At the hospital, Perez guides Alan through the hypnosis and helps him find a beach-like place in his mind where Louis is staying. Perez asks to talk to Louis, and Alan gives a response in Louis's voice. Louis finally finishes telling Alan what happened at the picnic. He blew out the candles and wished Peter was his real father so he would stay. After that, Natalie tried to give Louis some candy, but he wouldn't share with Peter. She was angry that he would even try, so she made up a story that Peter was drunk. Peter was suspicious about what the candy was, so he got angry and grabbed the jar from her. Louis ran away in fear, and Peter went after him to pull him away from the edge. He then accused Natalie of wanting to hurt their son, which made Natalie push him to make him stop talking. Then Natalie turned to Louis, so he did what she always wanted him to do and jumped into the water. The truth is that Natalie has always been the one to intentionally cause Louis's accidents. When the story is over, Alan wakes up at the same time Louis's heart stops, but Alan uses a defibrillator to bring Louis back to life. After some time, Alan will move out of Sophie's apartment and into his own. After that, he goes to Paris's mental hospital, where Natalie is staying because she has Munchausen syndrome by proxy. This means that she is a caretaker who makes problems for someone else in order to get attention from doctors and friends. Natalie used to hurt Louis directly, but as he got older, he figured out what she wanted and caused accidents on his own to earn her love. Natalie is doing well with her treatment right now, but she is also expecting Alan's child. Now, Violet is in charge of taking care of Louis. The boy thinks about whether or not being in a coma is really so bad, since he can stay with his dad and never get in trouble. But Peter says he is wrong and tells him about all the magic and possibilities that are waiting for him when he wakes up. Louis opens his eyes and thinks about the day Peter left and said he would always be with him. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, turn on notifications, and like the video to help the channel. Thank you for watching.